breaking on an independent United Kingdom.
Meanwhile, we have young girls being beaten and raped, then ignored, labelled liars, and left defenceless because they're white.
On behalf of Autolycus, this is Trent Holmgren with the Europa Report for the past week, September 9th to September 16th, bringing you the latest news on the continent regarding new political developments and the ever-ongoing refugee crisis. Let us begin with Austria, where a total of 11,158 non-white invaders were arrested for violent assaults, drugs, thefts, and sexual assaults committed during the first 6 months of this year. From NewObserverOnline.com, the figures obtained by the Austrian Freedom Party, FPO, after freedom of information requests and published in the Kronen Zeitung newspaper, reveal that most of the refugee criminal crimes were committed in Vienna, where 4,967 of the non-whites were arrested. The nationalities of those arrested were listed as Afghanistan, Algeria, Iran, Iraq, Morocco, Nigeria, and Syria. Also, the Austrian presidential election is likely to be postponed from October 2nd to November 27th or December 4th, after it emerged that there have been once again serious problems preparing postal ballots. According to the Kleine Zeitung newspaper, the Freedom Party of Austria, or FPO, has only agreed to a postponement if postal ballots are abolished completely, a demand that is unlikely to be met. The decision to postpone the election was taken after it emerged that the glue used to close the postal ballots for the rerun was not sealing permanently, and that this would inevitably lead to the result being successfully challenged once again. North of the border in Germany, a specialist task force has been created to combat the massive number of crimes committed by the flood of non-white invaders pouring into the country. From NewObserverOnline.com, called the Multiple Offender Immigrants Unit, or EGMTZ, the task force specializes in tracking criminals who are resident in invader centers. According to a report in the Stuttgarter Zeitung, the unit targets violent and sexual crimes by migrants. Three non-whites, an Algerian, a Moroccan, and a Somali, were arrested last week by a unit in the town of Bietigheim-Bissingen. The invaders were all accused of stealing electrical goods from local German houses in that area. Not to mention the burgeoning cost of providing welfare to migrants, which has tripled during the past 2 years, reaching 5.3 billion euros. The number of asylum seekers jumped 169% from 363,000 in 2014 to 975,000 in 2015, the sixth consecutive year of increases. In addition, the claimants were 67% male and 33% female in 2015, and almost 30% claimed to be minors. Some 63% of the invaders came from Asia, while 22% came from Europe, quote-unquote. That is, the Southwest Balkans, namely Serbia, Albania, Fyrom, Kosovo, and Montenegro. 13% from Africa. Almost none of these claimants actually qualify for asylum at all. Moreover, UN envoy Martin Kobler said in an interview published on Thursday, some 235,000 migrants and refugees in Libya are ready to make the dangerous Mediterranean crossing to Italy as soon as the opportunity arises. From USA.ForzaNuova.info, according to Italy's interior minister, nearly 128,400 migrants have arrived via the Mediterranean since the start of the year, which is a 5% jump over the same period in 2015. We have on our lists 235,000 migrants who are just waiting for the good opportunity to depart for Italy, and they will do it, Kobler told Italian daily La Stampa. Reinforcing security is the most important issue at the moment. If we have a strong and unified army, then the dangers of terrorism and human trafficking will cease, he added. Libya's UN-backed government of national accord, based in Tripoli, is struggling to assert its authority and has been facing staunch resistance from a revival administration based in the country's remote east. To make matters worse, Italy is in the middle of a period of amazing political and financial turmoil. On the one hand, the country faces a constitutional referendum that could lead to the fall of its government. Its banking system is, despite a rescue package for its weakest lenders, experiencing unprecedented problems thanks to a huge surfeit of non-performing loans. On the other hand, the country's problems with debt are enormous and are described by Citi as a 2.2 trillion euro whatever it takes headache. Essentially, the European Central Bank is bound by President Mario Draghi's statement that he will do whatever it takes to save the euro back in 2012, Citi argues. Italy has a public debt of more than 131% of GDP, and if that starts to go sour, things could get really ugly really quickly. As Citi notes, the euro might come under renewed pressure on Italian public debt, and European partners might not want to have Italy run by parties targeting debt restructuring. In Britain, London's Muslim mayor Sadiq Khan has continued his pro-Hillary Clinton tour of the United States by declaring that immigrants into the West should not be forced to assimilate. From Breitbart.com/London, His comments come hot on the heels of the Chicago Press exposing his connections to the Radical Nation of Islam leader Louis Farrakhan. Mr. Khan, who was elected to be London's mayor in May 2016, has also used his trip to claim that Republican candidate Donald Trump is playing into the hands of the Islamic State. In contrast to Mayor Khan, Foreign Secretary Boris Johnson claimed, "Migrants accepting to reach Europe by sailing across the Mediterranean should be turned back." In a press conference in Florence yesterday, Mr. Johnson suggested that ships involved in Operation Sophia, which have been picking up migrants and ferrying them to Italy, should instead send them back to North Africa. "I think personally they should be turned back as close to the shore as possible so they don't reach the Italian mainland and there's more of a deterrent effect," he said. The most notable event of the week was the election of Diane James as leader of UKIP. From Breitbart.com/London, the new party leader finished the race with 8,451 out of 17,970 votes cast in total at 47.6%. Mrs. James is a member of the European Parliament, or MEP, for South East England, deputy chairman of the party, and a seasoned media performer with experience out of politics, having trained as a business analyst before working in healthcare for more than 30 years. The competition had been dominated by factional infighting after immigration spokesman Stephen Wolfe, MEP, a longtime Farage supporter, was excluded from the race on a technicality by the National Executive Committee, or NEC, which has been observed to be dominated by an anti-Farage faction of the party. Mrs. James presented herself as a reliable choice to steady the ship after the referendum, choosing not to rush into formulating any new policies and instead refreshing and reviewing what she called the very successful 2015 General Election Manifesto. Mr. Farage did not endorse a candidate, yet he was the guest of honor at a dinner organized by supporters of Mrs. James and his close ally, Aaron Banks, who said that UKIP had no future and would be dead in the water unless she won. Moving on to Eastern Europe, where Hungarian Prime Minister Viktor Orban visited this past Wednesday the 13th, the Bulgarian-Turkish border, where he was awaited by his Bulgarian counterpart, Boyko Borisov, to join together the barbed wire fence that will soon cover the 259 kilometers of border with Turkey. From VisegradPost.com, the Bulgarian Prime Minister had asked the European Commission an emergency aid of 160 million euro to protect the border. Boyko Borisov would welcome a positive response from the Commission by Friday the 16th, day of the summit of the 27 in Bratislava. Orban added that if the European Union could find 3 billion euro to ensure the assistance of Turkey in managing its migration crisis, it could perhaps give some to Bulgaria. About 13,000 migrants have been recorded in Bulgaria since the beginning of the year. 4,000 illegal migrants have been arrested, with an influx that has doubled in August. Regularly, illegal migrants cross Bulgaria without being arrested. The Hungarian Prime Minister recalled how naive the EU in Brussels is for wanting to welcome migrants. Lastly, President Miloš Zeman received the Austrian FPO candidate Norbert Hofer on Monday, September 12. The friendly visit was concluded by the wish to strengthen Central Europe and enlarge the Visegrad Group by including Austria, and President Zeman gave his support to Norbert Hofer in the Austrian presidential election. Mr. Zeman and Hofer discussed several topics as the Benes decrees, which provided some of the confiscation of property of collaborators, traitors, ethnic Germans, and Hungarians, except for those who themselves suffered under the Nazis. They also formed a basis for the transfer of the former groups from Czechoslovakia, recalled the Prague Monitor. After their one-hour-long discussion, Mr. Hofer said the meeting took place in a wonderful atmosphere, and he expressed his wish to enlarge the Visegrad Group with the adhesion of Austria once he'd be president. This would give more voice to Central Europe, which would have more power, according to Mr. Hofer. The spokesperson of President Zeman, Yuri Ovkacek, declared that Mr. Hofer was pledging for a union within the union. Well, that was all for this week, guys. For KRS Radio, this has been The Europa Report. The Europa Report is a compilation of selected articles from the following sites: NewObserverOnline.com, USA.ForzaNuova.info, Breitbart.com/London, VisegradPost.com. Please support their efforts.